say, Lady Betty. We'll require rooms for tonight. I'm afraid to say we cannot cross over today.
Cross over? But we must, Sir Andrew, whatever it costs. We must get with us tonight.
I'm sorry, but it's not a question of cost, Lady Betty. There's a nasty storm warning. It makes it quite impossible to pull out the door until it has changed.
But we must go. We must. Can't you find a way?
I told you, Lady Betty, we have to wait.
Oh, you are doing this on purpose. You tried to stop me from coming to Dover, and now you stop me from crossing over.
Short of tying you up, I cannot stop you from going to France, or I cannot prevent you from going to France. But I must implore you reconsider. Percy would have said...
It is Percy I am going to save.
Lady Blakeney, I protest. I have done my best.
You have done your best. To bore me to tears. You hardly spoke a word in the carriage from London, but sat there. Your disapproval evident in every muscle of your body. I am tired of your English disdain.
I say.
But you do not, Sir Andrew. You say very little. And when you do, it is nothing I want to hear. You have become quite tiresome.
I? Tiresome? I had to accompany you in the middle of the night on a wild goose chase. Just because you virtually blackmailed me into coming with you.
I did not blackmail you. You insisted on coming with me. I did not want you. It would have been best if you were to stay in London.
Oh, yes. Percy would love to have his wife careering all over the countryside without an escort. He requires no less that I accompany you. I require no less of myself.
You are tiresome, Sir Andrew. If I could procure sleep without you, I would.
Lady Blakeney, I've told you. I've been down to the shore already. Not talked to one, not two skippers. And every sailor assures me, no one, do you understand, Lady Blakeney? No one could possibly pull out to Dover tonight.
Well then, I must resign myself. Have you been with him?
Oh, yes, my lady. And another is Sir Andrew. Both are quite ready.
There, Mrs. Jellyband. Do not worry yourself. You are not assisting in some illicit elopement. Heaven forbid. My lady has urgent family business in France. Sir Percy is away from home. That is it. Now send in some supper for us, and I'm sure Sir Percy will reward you doubly for looking after her ladyships.
I shall die with anxiety. Talk to me. Tell me all your news.
Well, the storm makes it quite impossible to pull out of Dover. It is lovely Chauvelin might be in the same quandary.
He may have left before the storm broke.
God grant me. He may even set sail and now be lying at the bottom of the sea. Most likely he is here in Dover. Shall I seek him out under my sword room?
Nay, Sir Andrew, not just. I do wish for that beast death, but this country does not permit of murder. It is only that my beautiful France that holds us not was done lawfully. So, Sir Andrew, if I was to fly away, tell me of Percy's adventures, his heroism. I want to hear everything.
Well, in order to effect the escape of the Comtesse and Suzanne, he dressed as a hideous old market woman who was struggling grey locks and a filthy cap. My, he would have set the gods laughing himself, and also the time he...
Distinguished is a master of disguise. Do you understand?
Citizen,
We are all actors of us, France.
Of course, you idiot. Whom else would you be serving?
If your loyalties are so easily won.